everyone, my name's Vanessa and I work at Hertfordshire Family Centre Service in Broxbourne. So hello to everyone who knows me and hello to anyone who's new here today. Today we're going to read a story and it's called Oliver's Vegetables and it's written by Vivian French. So I hope you enjoy listening to it. Finish up, Oliver, said his mum, or we'll miss the bus. Can't we walk to Grandpa's house? Asked Oliver. No, said his mother, it's too far. Hurry up. The best thing about Grandpa's house was the wonderful garden. I grow all my own vegetables, Grandpa said proudly. And look, all the lovely vegetables in Grandpa's garden. I don't eat vegetables, Oliver told Grandpa. I only eat chips. If you want chips, said Grandpa, you must find the potatoes. And if you find something else, you must eat that first with no complaints. Is that a bargain? And they're shaking hands, so I think they've agreed. Let's see what happens. Oliver ran around the garden, but he couldn't see any potatoes. They must be hiding, he said, and he pulled at the nearest leaves. Carrots, said Grandpa, just the thing for Monday lunch. Oliver ate his first carrot. Oliver took a long time making up his mind on Tuesday. Gran and Grandpa came to watch. Those crinkly leaves are pretty, he said at last. Are the potatoes here? It's spinach, said Grandpa. They had spinach for supper. That was good, said Oliver. On Wednesday, Oliver got up early. Potatoes are very important, he said, so they must have big leaves. Here they are, Grandpa smiled. That's rhubarb. They had rhubarb pie that evening. That was very good. It rained on Thursday. When it stopped, Oliver hurried outside. Have you found the potatoes? Grandpa asked. No, said Oliver. I've found slugs and snails. Are they eating my potatoes? Grandpa shook his head. That's cabbage. Oliver had two helpings. Very, very good, he said. On Friday, Oliver was sure that he had found the potatoes. When he pulled at the leaves, up came some beetroot. That night, Oliver ate all of his beetroot salad. Very, very, very good, he said. Look at that lovely colour. I love beetroot. On Saturday, Oliver played football. The ball landed in a tangle of sticks and leaves. Oliver was sure the potatoes weren't there. And Grandpa nodded. Peas, he said. Oliver had three helpings of pea soup that evening. Was that good? Asked Grandpa. No, said Oliver. It was delicious. Oliver rushed into the garden on Sunday. Here they are. How did you know? Asked Grandpa. They were the only things left, said Oliver. Oliver asked. You scrub the potatoes, said Gran, and I'll peel them. Grandpa can cut them up. Oliver, Gran and Grandpa sat down to eat. The door opened and in walked Oliver's mother. She saw the plate of chips. Oh dear, I did hope Oliver would eat something different while he was here, she said. Oliver and Grandpa looked at each other. His mother stared as they laughed and laughed and laughed, because we know he did eat those vegetables. Thank you for listening to the story. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you do the activity that was linked to the story. So we'll see you soon. Bye.